What's going on, y'all sons of fishes?
Today, we're going to be making beef jerky in an actual dehydrator.
Gotta try that beef jerky, baby. Oh yeah. Carolina cat, bass, and brim style.
Not in my roaster oven, so this is going to be different. All right, so what we're going to do today is we're going to put it on for medium for about 4 hours, but this is my first time doing it on a dehydrator, so y'all just hang out with me, and we're going to see how this works out. First of all, we've got to find the meat that we're going to use to make this jerky. I'm going to find my harvest. Found it. All right, so I cut the meat up, and I've got it seasoned, and we're gonna turn this dehydrator on, and this is a test run, y'all. I think I might use one or two racks. I don't have a lot of beef jerky. Can already feel the heat coming out of there, y'all.
12:13.
All right, it's 12:13 right now. So, I don't know. We'll check it periodically, and I got the time right here, so you'll know just like I know. And first and foremost, y'all, I just want to take a second out to say thanks for watching my videos. If I'm not fishing or camping, I'm always cooking gourmet meals.
Bowl and peanuts.
We keep it professional.
Making pizza.
All right, y'all. I took out the fruit leather tray. I left it in there at the very beginning because I was afraid of like drippings and stuff. But hell, it's looking pretty good. Looking dehydrated, y'all. And you can see, it hasn't been too long. 101, put it in at 12:13, I believe. And now it's 101, and it's definitely making progress. Now we wait.
Damn, they're looking like beef jerky, y'all. Oh my goodness. Oh my gracious.
That stuff's looking pretty good right now already. And it's been a little over an hour. I mean, I got it on medium. We're gonna check it again in another hour and see what's happening. All right, 3:15. So it has been in for 3 hours now, and I'm telling y'all what. This is starting to look like jerky. I also have some taste testers that came over to the house, and they're gonna taste this beef jerky and let us know what they really feel about it. This is a professional beef jerky taster. I'm sure you've had many beef jerky in your life. We have another beef jerky taster. She's not paying any attention. So we're gonna get other people's opinions, not just my opinion, on this beef jerky for the video today. Now, you guys don't know if I pay him off or not, but that's besides the point. This beef jerky is going to be off the chain. I went ahead and switched my racks because it's 3 hours in. I think we're going to do it for another hour or so. But I have flipped my jerky, and now I've switched the racks. So the top's on the bottom, bottom's on the top. Now we're going to see if, I don't know if it's going to help it or not, evenly wise. But I think another hour will be sufficient. All right, y'all. So it's been 4 hours, and I think that we've got jerky. So let's check it out. All right, I ripped off a couple pieces, and now we're going to have a taste test. All right, everybody's got their jerky?
Everybody's got their jerky.
You got your jerky?
Yeah.
You got your jerky?
Yep.
Got my jerky.
Mmm,
that's
good.
Hmm?
It's good.
This is great. This is off the chain.
I can't eat it.
Needs a little more salt.
I would buy this.
It needs more curing salt. But the texture?
Texture's great.
And
the flavor of the steak is true. Mm-hmm. It's steak true.
Yes.
You can taste the steak. It needs something, like more salt.
Yeah, definitely more salt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I agree.
Definitely more salt. But I didn't cure it in salt. Next time, I'll be marinating it in a salt cure in probably about 2-3 days. So I think that'll be it. All right, y'all. 4 hours on medium with the dehydrator. With the warring
Very
dehydrator.
Very
y'all, thanks for hanging out.